In this problem, we're given a velocity-time graph for an object moving in one dimension, and what we're asked for in part A is the displacement for this object on a given time interval, that's from 0 to 10 seconds, and then in part B, we're going to compute the average velocity for this object on the same time interval. So to find the displacement, we need the area under this curve, and we could just chop it into two trapezoids and use the formula for area of a trapezoid, but it's also possible to just chop it up into rectangles and triangles like this. So now we just have to find the areas of all of these things, and I'll start with our big rectangle here. That has a width of 6 seconds and a height of 2 meters per second. When we multiply those, we get 12 meters. Next, we do the big triangle. That has a width of 6 seconds and a height of 4 meters per second because the bottom of the triangle is at 2 meters per second and the top is at 6. So when I take 1/2 × 6 × 4, that gives me another 12 meters. Now the little triangle, a width of 4 seconds and a height of 1 meter per second, applying 1/2 base × height to that, we end up with 2 meters. And finally, the little rectangle, it has a width of 4 seconds and a height of 1 meter per second. So we get 4 meters from that. Adding all this up, we get our total displacement. So I have delta x is 12 plus 12, that's 24, plus an additional 6. So we get 30 meters. So next we're asked to compute the average velocity for this object from t equals 0 to 10 seconds. And it's so important that you don't misinterpret that word average. This does not mean an arithmetic mean. Average velocity means the total displacement divided by how long it took. So our average velocity is going to be delta x, that's our total displacement, divided by how long it took for that displacement to occur. We call that delta t. And so all we have to do is plug in the displacement from part A, that was 30 meters positive, and then divide by how long it took, and that was 10 seconds. And we arrive at this nice round answer of 3 meters per second for the average velocity. And I want to take a second to point out what the average velocity means in the velocity time graph. So there's our average velocity in the graph, and the physical interpretation of this is the speed that you would have to go to cover exactly the same displacement of 30 meters at a constant speed. So if we look at the area bounded under V bar, well, this is just a big rectangle with a width of 10 seconds and a height of 3 meters per second, and we get our 30 meter displacement by moving at a constant rate. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.